Namaste friends, welcome to all for Atta Yoga MCQ Series 3. Myself Naresh Katla. I am in this series. We are going to discuss a few important MCQs which I collected from the previous exam. In Atta Yoga, majorly I covered the Atta Yoga Pratipika and Gheranda Samhita, Adratnavadi, Siddha Siddhanta Paddhati and Shiva Samhita. Total 5 major Atta Yoga texts. So let's come to the first question. According to Gheranda Samhita, the Kapala Randra Dauti is the type of which Dauti? Danta Dauti, Vrit Dauti, Antar Dauti, Mulashodhan. So Kapala Randra Dauti is a part of Danta Dauti, and Danta Dauti is classified into 5 categories. You can see that whole Jardanta Mula is a cleansing of your teeth, Jifa Mula cleansing of your tongue, Kapala Randa cleansing of frontal lobe, and Karna Mula is classified into 4 and 5 because you are using both ears, that is a cleansing of 2 ears. So Danta Dauti is a 5 classifications. The previous another questions also framed, they asked from the net exam, especially Danta Mula Dauti. Options are 4 and 5 like. So most of the aspirants are in, they consider as a 4, but it's not, it's a 5. So here answer for this Kapala Randra Dauti is a part of Danta Dauti. Let's according to Gheranda Samhita, Valita and Palita Nasha are the benefits of. Valita and Palita is the wrinkle air, wrinkle and wrinkle of the skin are and grey hair can be eradicated, can be removed by practicing of which mudra as per Gheranda Samhita. Mandukya Mudra, Mahamudra, Kechari Mudra and Shakti Jalani. So Mahamudra is very good actually. And let's see. So here I given the all the list of Valita and Palita. Mandukya is very good for the Valita and Palita. So option 1 is the right answers. And it also helps to the maintain the youth and hair never grow white. So Mahamudra, indigestion, fever, enlargement, spleen, constipation, Kechari Mudra. The fatigue, you know, feel the overcome the mocha and shunga, trishna and means appetite and thirsty, alasya, no laziness, no disease, no death. Shakti Charani Mudra helps to the death, overcome the death, and Vigraha Siddhi, special contribution is Vigraha Siddhi can attain through the Shakti Charani Mudra, all diseases. So third question, according to Atta Yoga Pratipika, during the stage of Nishpatti, the vayu penetrated which gland? Hridaya Grandhi, Rudra Grandhi, Vishnu Grandhi and Brahma Grandhi. So there is a 4 states, and Arambha, Gata, Parichaya and Nishpatti, and except of Parichaya, there is no piercing of any gland in the Parichaya Avastha, and other Avastha, there is each stage one Grandhi, the knots are opened. So in especially Nishpatti, you will reach the Rudra Gandhi is open, and when Arambha Vastha is a Brahma Gandhi, and Gata Vastha Vishnu Gandhi, Parichaya Vastha, there is no gland not are open. You can see that this chart is a Parichaya Vastha, no Gandhi. Okay friends, next move the 4th question. Due to which reason does the body of yogi not get in contact with water and mud? By conquering Pranavayu, by conquering Udhanavayu, by conquering Samanavayu, by conquering Jnanavayu. By conquering mastery over the Udhanavayu, the yoga sadhana, yoga sadhaka not be contact with water and mud. This Udhana is uplifting force, is making light, so he won't touch water and mud. According to Atta Pradipika, which of the following Nada appear at lost stage of Nadana Sandhana? So Nadana Sandhana 4 stage I explained already. So in the which sound you hear first? Dhol and Shankha, Jarana and Ghanta, Megha Garjana and Samudra Garjana, Veena and Brahma Garjana, Brahmar Garjana. So in the Nadana Sandhana is your mind is more deeper and deeper. First, it you able to hear the very gross sound, then subtail sound. In this option, Dakti is the right answer. Megha Garjana and Samudra Garjana. You can see with the sloka reference also. Shrete Pradama Abhyase Nade Nana Vido Mahan. Tato Abhyase Vartaman Shrete Sukshma Sukshma. So, starting is a Pradama Abhyasa, this Nana Vida Mahan. It's a gross sound. Then it become very fine and very deep. Sukshma Sukshma sounds, very subtle sounds able to hear. So, there's a force Adama and Madhyasthiti and Uttama and upper level. What are the sounds can be heard? First, Adho Jaladiji Mutabheri Janjura Sambhava. So, in the lower state, Jaladiji means is a Megha Garjana and Madhya in the middle state, Marda Shankotyata Ganta Kahala Chastata. And final state you can say it's Ante Tu Kinki Kinki Veena Vashivina Brahmarina Swana Iti Nana Vidanadi Sriyante Deha Madhyaga. So Veena sound, Veena and Brahmarina. After Veena, then another last one is the Brahmari. Then Swana. These sounds can be here you passing through the different stage of Nadanusandhana. Okay. For this question, fifth question, our answer is Megha Garjana and Samudra Garjana. Try to remember, why I am giving this sloka reference and other explanation. The next time the questions may ask in this same concept, not direct questions they come. Indirectly, they will go through the other topic. So, try to cover whenever the questions you read, the related questions, related subject knowledge, gather it and clear your concept. Which Kriya is the best in Atta Kriyas according to Swatvaram? Basti, Trataka, Nauli and Neti. The Nauli is the best as per Swatvaram. Okay. According to Siddha Siddhanta Paddhati, what yield Sarvendriyana and Aharendriya Jaya? Sarvendriya Jaya and Aharendriya Jaya. So, overcome mastery over the all the Sarvendriyas, sensor organs and motor organs, Aharendriya Jaya. Overcome the Aharendriya Jaya. So, which is possible for, through only Pratyahar. Second is the right answer. Kundalini, Chakra, Nadi, etc. are related to which yoga? Karma Yoga, Hatha Yoga, Jnana Yoga and Raja Yoga. The Kundalini, Chakra and Nadis are closely associated with the Hatha Yoga only. Not Karma Yoga, not Jnana Yoga, not Raja Yoga. Raja Yoga is nothing but Ashtanga Yoga, Patanjali Yoga Sutra. Jnana Yoga and Karma Yoga related to wisdom and related to actions. There is no concept of Kundalini Chakra and Nadis. So, option 2 is the right answer. Pranayama is related to mind only, psych only, both body and mind, body only. Both body and mind, Pranayama. Chale Vate Chale Chitti. And it's both correlated. Which asana is beneficial in Gulma Roga according to Atapradipika? Machindrasana, Mayurasana, Dhanurasana and Pachimottana. Gulma Roga is related to piles and constipations and others are is related to Gulma Roga. It's very helpful by practicing of which is Mayurasana is very good for Gulma Roga. So you can see that by practicing of Machindrasana, you can awakening your Kundalini, appetite also increase and mostly deadly disease rogas can be cured. And Mayurasana, Gulma Roga, phlegm, bile, wind, appetite and deadly poison. So Gulma Roga, Vata Pitta Kapha Dosha also can be eradicated and deadly poison, any deadly poisonous snake also you can able to digest. Dhanurasana, that no benefits are not mentioned as per Satvarama. Pachimottanasana, awakening Shushumni, gastric fire, reduce obesity and all diseases. Okay friends, in Shiva Samhita, how many main nadis are mentioned? They are including Chitra Nadi. So Shiva Samhita, total 40 nadis are mentioned. If you including Chitra Nadi, total 15. If you get an Ataratnavari, Dashanadis, Ataratnavari Dasha and Garanda Samhita also. Dashanadis are main considered important nadis and even Atayoga Pratipika also is 10. Kataka Pratika, there is no Nadi concept actually. Shiva Samhita is especially Nadi and Chakras lead, even Garanda Samhita also. According to Garanda Samhita, which of the following food items are apatya? Apatya is prohibited food. Yava, Kulatta, Mutka, and Taila. So, Kulatta and Taila is the apatyahar. You can see that sloka. First, Kulatta, Masur, Unda, Kushmanda, Shakadandakam, Dushmumbil, Kele, Kapityam, Chakanta, Bilvam, Palashaka. So, Kulatta and Taila. 2 and 4 is the right answer. 2 and second option. Which of the following are the causative factor for type 2 diabetes? Stress, relaxation through meditation, lack of exercise, autoimmune destructions of beta cells. Autoimmune and stress. 1 and 4 is the main causative factor. 1 and 4. 1 and 4. 4th is the right answer. According to Garanda Samhita, which of the following food items are patya? Recommended food which can be yogi consume. So takra, grita, navaneeta and taila. The grita means ghee and navaneeta. These are the recommended food. So you can see the second line, navaneeta, grita, kshira, gunda, shakkaradi, chakshavan. So these are the recommended food. You can go through the other lists which is mentioned in this sloka. Which of the these practices are beneficial for value-based education. Pranayama, Yama, Niyama and Shatkarma. Value-based. Value means ethics. The ethics can be accomplished through practicing of Yama and Niyama only. So, 2 and 3 only right answers. Do's and don'ts. Second. So, this fourth one is the right answer. In lumbar spondylosis, which asanas are contraindicated? Contraindicated means not supposed to practice. Padastasana, Bhujangasana, Ardha Chakrasana, Pavanamuktasana. Lumbar spondylitis, Pavanamuktasana and Padastasana. Forward bendings are avoided. 1 and 4 is right answer. So, 4th option. According to Atapradipika, as a result of Brahma Grandhi Vedana, the sadhaka become ojasvi, disease-free, wise and good nature. So, he become ojasvi, and disease free, wise and good nature. It's a very tricky question. One is compulsory ojasvi, 1 and 4 good nature, or 1 and 2 disease free. 2, first one is the right answer. First one is the right answers. Okay friends, next, in depression, which of the following yogic practices are prohibited? Shavasana, Suryavedana Pranayama, Kapalabhati Kriya, Brahmari Pranayama. Shavasana is a contraindicator for depressions because it's mind mode in a depression stage if you give the relaxation asana like Shavasana and Brahmari Pranayama. So 1 and 4 is the right answer. Option 1. And which of the following asanas are of the balancing type? Vrikshasana, Kukutasana, Ardhachandrasana and Garudasana. So except of Ardha Chandrasana, these three are remaining in balancing postures. So, option 1 is the right answer. According to Garanda Samhita, the result of Pratyahara are conquering on soul, destructions of Kama, the enemies, control over mind, control over vrittis. So, choose the correct answers in this among these options. So, it helps to the destructions of Kama, the enemies, and control over the mind. 2 and 3 are the right answers. According to Yoga Pratipika, which practices are beneficial in wrinkle and graying of hair? Mahamudra, Mahabandha Mudra, Vibrita Karani Mudra and Mahaveda Mudra. So, Vibrita Karani is very good. And next, Vibrita Karani destroy the old nails, Mahaveda Mudra also. So, Mahaveda Mudra and Vibrita Karani helps to wrinkle and graying of air. So, third and fourth is the right answers. Two. According to Atapadipika, which disease occurs due to vitation of vayus? Eye disease, cough, asthma, and indigestion. So, in first chapter, then the second chapter is mentioned about if wrong practice of pranayama causes swasa kacha is a rogas nanavida ikka swasa kasha chakshira karnakshi vedanam. So eye disease, no, cough, asthma and karnakshi vedanam ikka swasa kasha chakshira karna. So this except indigestion, this all three are mentioned. So 1, 2, 3. No, even eye disease are not mentioned. Cough and asthma, ikka and swasacha, kasacha, kasacha is a cough and swasacha is related to asthma. So hiccups, ikka means hiccups, kshira karnaksha. So there is no eye chakshu related disease. Cough and asthma, 2 and 3 is the right answer. And which of the following are obstacles in yoga sadhana? Sahasa, utsaha, prayasa and prajalpa. Utsaha, sahasa, utsaha, sahasa, prayasa, prajalpa, niyamanugraha, janasangha, laulyamcha, shindriyoga, vinashyati. So utsaha is there and obstacles. Atyaha, prayasa and prajalpa is these are the obstacles for yoga sadhaka. Atyahara, prayasa, cha, prajalpa. Prayasa and prajalpa. Prajalpa means excessive talking. Productiveness, prayasa means excessive exertion, overwork. Asanas are classified in which of the following category? Meditative, reactive, spiritual and social. Meditative postures and relaxative, actually spelling mistakes and relaxative postures. So 1 and 2 are the right answers. 1 and 2. Which of the following asanas are back bending type? Uttana Padasana, Bhujangasana, Chakrasana and Sarvangasana. Bhujangasana and Chakrasana is the back bending poses. 2 and 3 are the right answers. According to Atapradivika, Mahamudra is a beneficial in which disease? Insomnia, indigestion, skin disease and Swasaroga. You can see here, Kshaya, Kushtu, Guda, Varda, Gulma. So, indigestion and skin disease is very good for Mahamudra. And assertions and reasoning based questions. So, assertion is saying, Mithahara is advised for yoga practitioners. Mithahara means kept 1/3 part of stomach empty, which is the helpful in yoga sadhaka. Yes, so option both are correct. Correct explanation of me. One is the right answer. And pranayama is essential before the practice of dharana. Practice of pranayama leads to removal of covering over light of sattva and mind become able to perform dharana. Yes, both are right. Correct explanation of me. And question number 30, assertion and reasoning based questions. Pranayamic practice are very different in purpose and technique from the other breathing exercise. Yes, pranayama practice is varied and involve different mechanism through which the result of particular yoga practice are obtained. Yes, correct explanation of here. One is right answer. And Nadi Shodhana is essential before the practice of Kumbhaka. Prana does not flow in impure nadis, so due to failure in achieving Unmani Bhava, the sadhana could not be completed. Yes, of course, true. Correct explanation of A. Both A and R true. And in the technique of Lakushinka Prakshalana, arrange the following asana in sequential order. Tiriya Tadasana, Tadasana, Tiriya Kujangasana, Udhyakarshanasana, Katachakrasana. First, Tadasana and Tiriya Tadasana. Then, Katachakrasana, Tiriya Kujangasana, Udhyakarshanasana. Okay? You can see this figure also here. Tadasana is a stretching, Tiriya Tadasana, Kati Chakrasana, Bhujangasana, Udhyakarshanasana. Next, 33 question and Upaprana, least one is given. Upapranas and least two, their functions are given. Naga, Devadatta, Dhanujaya, Trikara and Kurva. Naga, anger and thrust, blinking of eyelid, yawning and hiccups and bletchings. So, Naga helps to the bletching. Devadatta is yawning, Dhanunjaya is hiccup, Krikara is hunger and thirst, Kurma is blinking of eyelids. So Naga, fourth one. So this one is the right answer. Fourth one. according to Adaratnamali, match the least one with the least two. So least one is given Daudik Karma, Nedik Karma, Basti Karma, Chakri Karma and Noli Karma. List two is given the diseases. Asharoga, Mandagni, Kasa and Swasa and Gulma and Friharoga and Drishti Dosha. Daudik Karma is very good for the Kasa and Swasa Roga. One is three. And B, Neti Karma is the Neti is Drishti Dosha. So four, yes, and Vastik Karma is a Gulma Roga and Priha Roga. So option 3 is the right answers. Chakri Karma is very good for the Arsha Roga and Naudi Karma is stimulate the Mandagni. And Giranda Samhita match least one with the least two. So Shat Karma, Pranayama, Asana and Mudra. Shat Karma is good for firmness. Choose the correct answers. Okay. Firmness, steadiness, lightness, purification. Shat Karma is a purification. One is four. So, and Pranayama is lightness. Asana is firmness. Mudra is the steadiness. So, this is the right answers. Mudra is the steadiness. So, third one is the right answer of the question. And according to Siddha Siddhanta Paddhati, arrange the following chakras in ascending order. Akasha Chakra, Kanta Chakra, Burhut Chakra, Nirvana Chakra and Talu Chakra. So, in the Siddha Siddhanta Paddhati, total 9 chakras are mentioned. So, usually you see in other text is given Shat Chakras or 6 chakras or 7 chakras, which name completely different from Siddha Siddhanta Paddhati of the chakras, 9 chakra concept. So very famous, we know Muladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anada and Vishuddhi and Agna, but here the chakra names you can't see, it's a different terminology used. So you can see that how it is come. First is first come to the Kanta Chakra, first is the Kanta Chakra, then Bruhu Chakra, Talu Chakra, Nirvana Chakra and Akasha Chakra. First Brahma Chakra, so, but is this sequence is first Kanta Chakra. First starting, remaining, here is a 5 chakras, remaining 4 chakras, above that 4 chakras are there, Brahma Chakra, Swadhisthana Chakra, Nabi Chakra and Vridaya Chakra. So first Kanta Chakra 2, then Kanta Chakra, then after Bruhu Chakra 3. Bruhu Chakra, Talu Chakra. So in this options are little confused, just go through this one. This is the right answers. Just options are mistake, typing mistakes. So friends, I hope you're getting some glimpse, some insight. It helping a lot. I considering just to give your response. Any changes, any corrections, leave in comment box. Thank you very much.